Good motherfucking morning, motherfucking ladies. Good motherfucking morning, senoritas. How are y'all doing today on this most beautiful, not Monday, Tuesday mornings? We good? Chillin', Gucci. Tamagotchi. Shit. It's not Tuesday. What day is it then? If not Tuesday, it is Wednesday, actually. You are not wrong. State of play today. Yes, what time was that? 9 or 10 or 11? 11. 11 p.m. Alright. Very good. Suits me well. Will you try Street Fighter 6 of the Season 2 patch? No, I don't think so. No. All right, very good. Let's see here. We got some Re Zabos. Bergman, double art. Brazil, you me bang bang. Soda popper, iFud and merchant. Jackie Chan, cocoa cake, 5 and 2 years on Onisan. Thank you very much. Thank you for these 2 years. For Storm Army Club, Bling. Nice try, motherfucker. But here's your cringe fest at least. Pew! Join the badge. While it lasts. Nothing lasts forever. Nothing like forever. Yo. Alright. Massive storm here. Massive storm. 35 to 45 meter seconds wind. Lightning and the thunder. How about you stop being a bitch? Alright. How about you stop being a bitch? Let's see here. Okay, this goes here. I think I have to charge my mouse as well. Potentially. Energy cooler. I think we're 2, 3, 4, 9 months. Jack 8 today. Pause, man. Jack 8. It's possible. We can try. We can try. Why not? I don't see why not. It's possible. Either way. Let's see. No further links, Joanna. Thank you very much. State. Okay.
じゃつまんないよ。こんねってばよ。どうせ何も変わんねえんだ。だって真実なら兄さんの方が上手だって。俺だってわかるよ。たった1年で卒業したんだってさ。兄さんはそうやっていつも俺を厄介者扱いする。俺はいつも一番だから。英雄。よし、決めた。サスケ、どうなんだ。
父さん。
されて、いくら我々警務部隊でも捕捉状がなければ逮捕できない。英雄。 これがうちはの基本忍術だ。因はさっき教えた通りだ。やってみろ。
カタン豪華球の術、はあ、
やはりイタチのようにはいかんか。
何それ。
その後一気に吐き出すように。イタチのようにはいかんか。まだ早すぎたのかもしれぬな。
好都合だ。里の防衛を名目に新たにパトロール隊を組織する。うちはの警務部隊から職務を移行し戦力を削ぐの
だ。では手発通りに頼む。
里が変わらなければどうする。うちはをまとめたとて里の者の不信は早々消えぬぞ。
動け。
This fucking sound effects, man. What the fuck?
父さん、母さん。
ESL audio guy.
Nisa.父さんと母さんが。どうして兄さんが。
愚かなる弟よ、己の器を測るためだ。
Good ending.
People are quitting concepts like pornography completely. People are embracing concepts like celibacy. There is something called the nofap movement. So, sir, can you explain the role of celibacy in spiritual growth as well as mental growth? Like, what does it do for a human being's mind?
See, the first thing, celibacy ka sabse bada fayda kya hai? Aapka focus bahut amazing ho jata hai. You attraction to distraction is over. So.What happens is, जब आपका focus बहुत भयंकर है तो आपको कोई disturb नहीं कर सकता।
You will experience like better physical health, yeah. Your energy will improve and your mental clarity will improve.
Whatever profession you are in, right? Whether it's a corporate world, whether it's a creative world, or it can be as simple as being confident in front of people. It's unreal. I mean, you have to practice to experience it.I'm not even saying years, right? Just do it for 21 days and, and see how you feel about it.
Celibacy has its own benefits. It is its own charm. It has its own energy level. Definitely it has.
Celibacy ke na do fayde hai. Material level pe bhi fayda hai, which is physical level. Aur spiritual level pe to fayda hai hi aapko bahut bada.
So, there was this research done by like three scientists and they had...They just wanted to see like what semen constitutes. They found that 90% of it was water and 10% of it was nutrients. And those were the nutrients which included most of the minerals, cholesterol and other minerals which are foods for the brain.
Like, matlab, it's basically like you're putting petrol into your brain. Yes.
It's how much forward modern science has gone into it. Yeah. But Ayurveda is very clear about the fact that it moves
upwards and nourishes the brain. Pause the video. Pause it, Mr. Force. Further links allowed H. Mr. Force, come to America and become a wizard.Please, please, 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 Mr. Force.
Become a wizard. I'm already a wizard.
In a bunch of our podcasts, that there's a whole world of science that the world of science hasn't discovered yet.
What do scientists do? What do you say? Scientists? What?
Research?
Why? Analyze. Research is the word, right? Mm. Which means you never say scientists are searching. Mm.Technically, scientists are supposed to search, right? What does research mean? It's already there. They're researching it.
Yeah,
so, what's there 5,000 or how many ever years ago they are researching it.
Celibacy ka sabse bada strength kya hota hai? Urdhvare thi.
5,000 years ago. Power,
and so much so that you can procreate and recreate a new life. You can give birth to a new child. And if you can actually save your semen and start flowing upwards, according to Ayurveda, start nourishing your brain cells in such a way that you build no dietary amulet can do it. And plus, you also build uncommon intelligence and photographic memory.
Even for example, sex for people, they don't do it all the time. I don't think anybody does it all the time. They have, times when they feel the urge in the body. Unfortunately, we think sex is bad. Sex should not be taken as a bad or a sin. In this country, it was not seen as a sin. It's a Western thought we adopted in this country for several centuries now. If you are using your energy into a creative channel, you are putting it into some creativity or in service, or even in studies, sex is not a botheration at all. Nobody is bothered about sex when they have exams. At those times, they are so busy. And when you have an important mission to accomplish in life, that is not some issue that comes into your head. It's one energy in the body that is either sex energy, or it converts itself into love, compassion, anger also. People who suppress sex, sometimes they become very angry. The same energy gets an outlet in anger. But if the same energy is channeled through meditation as love and compassion, then you see that you are in bliss all time. You should not say this is bad or sin, I have to get out of it. No, it's a natural instinct. Honor it. And then go beyond.
We live in a society where people chase physical pleasures a lot. The greatest pleasures are mental and spiritual, but not.
Alright. Chat, you see?
On April 15th, 1989, a tragedy took place at the Hillsborough Stadium in Sheffield, England, during a football game between Liverpool and Nottingham Forest. Police negligence led to massive overcrowding in the seating pens, which led to a human crush. The crush was so devastating, 96 people lost their lives, and 766 people were reported injured from asphyxiation. Hillsborough Stadium was chosen to host as neutral grounds for the teams. Liverpool fans gathered at the northwest part of the stadium called Leppings Lane, while Nottingham fans entered at the southeast end. Efforts were made to keep the fans from crossing each other's paths, because at the time, there were many hooligans among the fans, and often fights would break out. While this was an attempt at keeping the peace, there were more Liverpool fans than there were Nottingham. Nottingham's side had 29,800 combined capacity and 60 turnstiles for people to enter through. The northwest end of the stadium only had 23 turnstiles that met with 24,256 fans. There were normally other turnstiles around the Liverpool entrance for people to use, but because of the segregation policy, many of them were closed off so sports rivals couldn't cross each other's paths. While there was a public announcement to discourage more people from attending, the police, clubs, and local authorities at the event were more worried about the hooligans and fan fights. The game was scheduled to start around 3 p.m. Around 2:20 p.m., 350 people arrived off of three chartered buses. Upon their arrival, many of the fans wanted to enjoy their time with family and friends, and weren't in a hurry to try and get into the stadium. This caused congestion to build up in a short period of time. On the TV and radio, announcers told people to stay home if they didn't have a ticket because of how packed it was. Between 2:30 and 2:40, people started to cram up at the turnstiles in front of Leppings Lane. At 2:46, John Motson, the BBC football commentator at the event, could already tell there was an imbalance of distribution among the people, and signaled the cameraman to get a shot to show just how many people were there. A police constable at the event requested that the game be delayed by 20 minutes to try and ensure safer passage for the fans, as the request had been granted at a game 2 years prior. However, the request was denied. Outside the stadium, the crowd started to form a bottleneck. There were more fans arriving than there was a way for them to get in. People were showing tickets to the wrong turnstiles, but couldn't leave when denied entry because of the people behind them. At 3, the game began as scheduled, and the fans outside could hear the cheers of fans inside the stadium. There was an estimated 5,000 people just at the turnstiles trying to get in, and this aroused safety concerns from police. The superintendent that would be in charge of order for this game was David Duckenfield, who had very little experience to no experience in how to keep order and maintain a sold-out stadium crowd. Worried that the crowd was going to pose a major fatality risk, he ordered exit gate C to be opened to relieve the masses. This exit gate was normally used for people departing the stadium, not going in. Then to help relieve pressure, gates A and B were then opened as well. The crowd poured in the pens at free will. No one was even checking ticket stubs at this point. Initially, there was a rush when the fans entered, but it turned into a steadily paced walk. Even at a steady paced walk, the fans began to fill a tunnel that led into the already overcrowded central pens 3 and 4. The rushing crowd had no way of knowing they were being led into an area that didn't have enough room, or what was happening in the front pens. People in the front pens were suddenly rushed from behind, and pinned against each other and the barrier that separated the fans from the game on the field. For some reason, while police or stewards were usually present to direct people where they should go, they were not there to do that. A BBC report speculated that if police had positioned the two patrol horses on the field into the crowds correctly, they could have directed fans into the side pens. With the game just starting, there were still fans arriving into the pens from the rear entry gate. During the crush, people were so packed in they couldn't turn, they couldn't bend, or even raise their arms. Some fans, like 19-year-old Sarah Hicks, who went to the game with her sister, father, and mother, couldn't be pulled out by people trying to help. A man trying to save Sarah Hicks wasn't able to do anything when he tried to pull her up. He lost his grip on her, couldn't reach her again, and could only watch in terror as she cried and became asphyxiated. Her sister, 15-year-old Victoria Hicks, was also killed in the crush. People above in the west stands were pulling people up from the Leppings Lane terrace. In the confusion, police gathered in front of the fence and created a cordon to keep fans from escaping over the fence, thinking it was just a pitch invasion. They were pushing fans back into the crush. At approximately 3:05, a football player kicked a shot that hit the pole of Nottingham's goal barrier. Possibly as a result of the excitement, that very moment there was a surge in Pen 3, and one of the metal crush barriers gave way. This sent people flying over each other, and unfortunately, on top of any injured people who were lying in front of the barrier after managing to escape. South Yorkshire Superintendent Greenwood realized what was happening and quickly told the referee. By the time he noticed, however, fans had already broken open one of the locked gates in the barrier and were fleeing by climbing over the fence. Other fans trying to help made holes in the perimeter of the fence. The intensity of the crush broke multiple terraces. The referee called the game and sent the players to their respective locker rooms. Nottingham fans who didn't understand what was going on at the time thought there was a pitch invasion and started whistling their anger at the Liverpool side and chanting.
Unfortunately. Funny guy.
Six, this is Dragon. Press the target.
Copy, pressing the target.
Go!
I did see Avatar 2. I don't remember. I think it was not good. That's so good. That's okay. The 3D. Okay, I'm sorry. Like, why is he holding his hair instead of just punching this guy or preventing his throat from getting slit? He's just holding his hair like this. Right? Just punch him. Just fucking take the dive. Just do something with your fucking hands. What? Least retarded? Did you dumb?
I love you.
Lola!
Yasuo, I love you, bro. No, not be gay, Matter. I know if you be gay. If I dream, I see bro say why sleep with me. If you hear say die, I'm a killer.
AY Live Abuja, powered by Corporate World Entertainment Limited.
Please show some love for the maddest of them all. It goes by the name Ah-Ah-Ro-Ro!
Bro, the audio is...
Well, listen to me.
Jesus.
Listen to me. You not get money, you dey pray for long life. Who wants to defeat you? You, if you want, die. Not stress us. Listen to me. Now you not get shape. Now you the hotter waiting Beyonce we are online. Ladies, you not get shape. You the hotter waiting talking Maki while we are. Now they don't bring the clothes now. You wear that now. You look like a rainbow. You gotta say this is what I hotter and this is what I get. No, now your shape. Then not meet up with waiting you hotter. If your shape now for rapper, tie rapper. Yeah, me. Any man who travel come up for this country for 10 years. Travel, go outside country. Come back to this country. Can't speak this English, said there is no place like home. He not bring money. If you bring money, not go speak that English. You not know, say there is no place like home before you go. You are.
Oh what the fuck is going on?
Oga Wood, I won't do gay work. Not be this guy your head though. I not like the way they look me. Not be come. I just they perform. Not use me there. Even I won't do gay work. We are gonna touch. Now this head. Oga, na joke I do. Oh! You get to see the do. Not the way you're not doing me. Hey, I don't know where you do. No, my brother, I'm too happy for them. Thank God said they come back. Oh. Smarting. Peter for do conductor.
Is this really or not?
Let you join your ballet.
I love you.
Hola. Yes, sir. I love you, bro. No, not be gay, matter. I know if you be gay. If I dream, I see bro say why sleep with me. If you hear say die, I'm a killer. See, make I tell you something. This waste for the wine. Now only for show like this, have you wine up? If I tell you happened to me last month, they invite me for army barracks. This Chicago play song, but it didn't enter my head. I got the wine with. Army general wife. Call up my waist. Now I tell the husband. Say, look at your mate. I stay in bedroom for like 2 weeks.
Bro, I don't understand what the fuck is saying, and all you guys is retarded. What is this shit?
Close your eyes, and you will find yourself.
When I was a boy, my mother used to tell me a story of a demon king and his army. They brought fire and terror to the land. Until they faced the protector of the people. The white monkey.
There you are. You are a beast.
In this city, the rich don't see us as people.
Give me the job no one wants to do. I'll do it.
Anyone who forgets their place doesn't turn out well for them.
This is not the place to work if you can't handle that sort of stuff.
Every day, I've prayed for a way to protect the weak.
I've got an answer to every prayer. I call on Nikki.
Minaj, big bumper. Nice headlights. Let's boogie!
There's a license. Indian John Wick.
Forsen, this is what you're up against when... You dare leave Orange Rank.
You need to fight for your mother, for all of us.
No for the legs.
And it will not quiet your soul, my son.
Don't call me son.
It's time to remember who you are. But only love kills more when will they learn?
Just one small ember can burn down everything.
I mock you.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for a fucking fight?
One, two, three.
doesn't look bad. They don't have the usual silly Bollywood stuff in it. Like, they had looked to have pretty good choreography. And not the invincible tear out a fucking light pole from the street kind of shit, you know. Dead set, thank you for the 4 years. Forsen puke, thank you, Forsen on the device for turning me into a weeb. You're welcome, enjoy the badge. Look at them. Look at Tim. There we go. Normandy, Wuben, you, and Zrail. Thanks for 7, 37.
I'm Ryan.
What can I do for you?
I was pointing last.
Is this one safe? Yeah, I guess so.
What
Doesn't
can I
remember
do
if I
for
watched
you?
this.
I was partying last night with some frat guys.
Probably, because I
I
saw the
passed
movie
out.
A long time ago.
I must have fallen down and broken something because I haven't been able to walk right since.
We're gonna take X-ray now.
Okay.
To be sure.
Okay. This is comfy. Hold your breath. Don't move.
Is that the Queen of England?
Es un carrito. Un carrito juguete. Estuvieron un party ayer y todo el mundo pastado y se estaban temblando unos a los otros y eso. Estaban todos drogados ya. Estaban drogados anoche. Pues nada.
I have no idea.
That's not part of you. That's something extra.
I would have known if I ate that.
No, you wouldn't be able to swallow that. That's just a car toy.
Well, how did a car toy get there?
Maybe you stuck it up your ass.
I wouldn't stick anything up my ass.
Have you ever seen anything like that?
No, I never seen that in there. I see it's a toy car all over, but no, never in somebody's rectum.
You can't get it out? You don't have to?
No, I'm a physician, but I practice this, X-ray only.
You think maybe I can just, you know, poop it out?
You won't be able to poop it out. In fact, it will hurt you. In fact, I don't think it's even good for you that you poop it out.
What will happen if you take X-lax? Will that help?
No, they take X-lax, but he gets a lot of diarrhea, but no cough. You just go to the doctor, you don't talk to anybody, your girlfriend or to your boyfriend or to whatever. You don't tell nobody, right? He already knows that too many people.
Thank you for taking care of me.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks again.
Why is it? Why is that physician so weird? Like, don't tell anyone. Like, it's the most shady thing in the world to have a toy car up your ass in this world.
How dare you take my 20 and not view mining? I'll be alerting the authorities about this very soon. Thankfully, I have received my Coinbase refund and am flush with cash. Now view my link so you can learn something about the game you are trying to play.
Coinbase refund. I'll check it. Just don't fire the links, please. I said it already once, twice. real ending. Christian Park. Free time well spent, yeah.
White power!
White power!
White power!
White power!
White power!
White power!
They're one of the world's most controversial organizations. Now, 60 years since the birth of the African-American Civil Rights Movement, the Ku Klux Klan are on a recruitment drive for new members, including children. With special access to a recruitment rally at a secret location, we go inside the movement to meet the members and uncover how they're planning to take up military-style training for what they claim is the first time in their history.
We're going to try to move into another direction with the Lowell White Knights, and that is starting to arm train, hand-to-hand combat, and stuff like that just for the upcoming battle.
Established 150 years ago, the Ku Klux Klan have long been associated with racism, cross-lighting, and even murder.
Really?
Today, the Klan is made up of an estimated 6,500 members across the USA, and they're traveling across America in a bid to attract new recruits. On the evening before their latest rally, we join them in the state of West Virginia on a night ride.
Night ride is an old Klan term. When the Klan went out on a night ride, they went out and patrolled the streets and sort of vigilante style.
Today, night rides consist of dropping leaflets in the local area.
Distributing these flyers for recruitment purposes. We put them in these bags, we add some rice for weight, toss them out the window into someone's driveway.
Parents like Sam and Amanda have brought their young boys, 14-year-old Mike and 11-year-old Dustin, to West Virginia for the recruitment drive.
I enjoy things like today because I'm being around people and not discussing people. Not your dad.
We spoke to criminologist and civil rights lawyer, Professor Brian Levin, who believes the targeting of children is consistent with the Klan's recruitment drive.
The Klan is aiming for a younger demographic for a couple of reasons. First, to keep the organization alive. The Klan has traditionally been aimed at an older audience. In addition, though, youth provides it with a more relevant social and political base, as well as some technological know-how as well, so that they can access the internet.
And the Klan are now appealing to children online. Mum Amanda believes racial minorities could have a bad influence on her sons.
The kids in school, you know, the black minorities, the Mexicans, I think they're taking their parents' drugs and bringing it to school and trying to make money off of it because their parents are so worried about doing drugs than providing for their own children. That's what I think.
Members of the Klan since birth, the boys have become regulars to such events and have even taken part in cross-burning rituals.
I do remember, like, my first cross.
How did it feel?
Feel good.
And Amanda wants the boys to have an active role in the Klan in the future.
Why does he have a green one? Why does this guy have a black one?
Working on Klan and raising more kids, white kids. And show them the values of the Klan.
The next morning, heavily armed security teams man the gates.
He's the Grand Dragon. And how do you know that?
It's a Remington R1 1911 45 caliber.
They claim members are from a number of professions.
We got police officers in the Klan. We got lawyers. We got doctors. Your next door neighbor could be in the Klan. You'll never know it.
The rally brings different factions of the Klan together, including the Lotties, which stands for Ladies of the Invisible Empire, who hold a bake sale.
We go all over the United States to help families in need of shelter, food, and especially the children, because they cannot take care of themselves, right? Exactly, and the elderly, especially. Yes. Yeah. Mm. Especially the elderly.
Yeah, all that sugar is super good for them.
The rally gives members the opportunity to socialize and even exchange gifts.
Well, what better to give my imperial family than a knife, right? But I think I'll paint it black, because it's funny. And it is funny.
Why has it got a noose on it?
Well, because I had string sitting at the house.
As the rally gets underway, Klan Dragons deliver speeches on their views on race, sexuality, and even the media.
You see, this state is a majority white state, a civilized Christian state. Unlike California, where they let the zoo animals walk
Christians
free. Christians
seem super civilized.
Anybody who does not believe me, look at Michigan. The whole state's bankrupt. It's a majority black state with 3 murders happening every day. Just goes to show you what happens when you take the nigger out of the jungle, but you can't take the jungle out of the nigger.
If I were to push the envelope just a little bit more, and I said that I hate fags because homosexuality is forbidden by God's law.
Praise God for AIDS. And these Jewish puppets who want to sell our ideals just for...
They really hate everyone, huh? U.S. I don't even know. Are there any people in these? I don't think it's not war crimes. I don't know if it's to us. Probably, maybe. I don't know. Maybe. One tap by Scam NL. Thank you, Prime Sub. Real Monster C. Sandman Junk Stevie. Thank you, boys. Welcome back. Cable U and I Hyro with the 3 years. Boop. Shoot a badge. Literal death. Yeah, but you don't see the stuff. You don't see the actual death. You don't see any people. It's just statistics. I think it's fine, but...
Get ready for the next
Tekken 8, Joshi Mitsu rank match. That flash parry is so fucking stupid.
Round 2. 재부팅을 하겠습니다.
Such a troll character.
아이고.
Taking off tier.
아, 좀 들어도
20k views. 50k views plus. Man, follow the rules, sir. Alright, happy. Thank you for 6 years. Should a badge. No message. 2 years from folks. 2 years. Hey, Mr. Force, it's been 2 years. Wasn't happy. Force and fist. Thank you, man. It's Toby, 3 years. Hello, Mr. Force. Happy birthday. It's not my birthday. Maybe it's yours. It's your badge. Silly parrot with 1 year. And Force, I'm a big fan of your stream. I have one question. Is this a Force parrot related stream of or NAR? What? I don't know what the fuck that means. I actually never heard that in my entire life. Is this Zoomer lingo? Get that shit out of my fucking chat, man. Get that shit out of my fucking chat, man. Alright, state of play. Later, we're trying a new character today. Okay, chat. Why are you running? All right, what's the DDoS pro? The DDoS forecast for today, chat. Forsen, why new character again? Yeah, you gotta try a few characters. You know, you gotta see what's up. You gotta see what's up. I haven't had time to. To lab anything today. I woke up early. I had other stuff to do today. Oh, fuck my asshole. Put a toy car up my ass, chat.
Chat, stop bitching about the views I pay and you watch Brosi. Those are the rules. Maybe get your money up. And you can see what it's like to live like me. Better Coinbase refund. I can't believe you succumbed to their whining, Forsen, while I was typing.
It's not their whining, I just didn't notice it. Because people were following the rules for so long that I did not check, alright? The link was fine, but everyone was following the rules, alright? Alright, who are we trying out today? I haven't labbed anyone, I have no idea about the punishers and whatnot.